testimony of his walk with God. Amen. And all is that all we need to do. Amen. It's just be mindful and listen to see what God has to say to us. Amen. Those of you that know prayer, you ought to be reaching to pray. Amen. For God is in the moving business. Hallelujah. Before he come, we're going to ask that Brother Boyd comes with a selection. Amen. Amen. God is good.
All the time.
And all the time. God is good. Hallelujah. Let's give him a hand clap as he comes.
Praise the Lord, everybody. Come on, let's clap our hands one more time. Let's come on, clap our hands. We can do better than that. We're grateful, being grateful for Christ. Hallelujah. Anybody know in God is able? Yes. Let's see the need of our belief. Let's start things according to the power and right with you.
I see the way.
Don't give up on God, cause he won't rely upon you. Don't give up on God, cause he won't rely upon you. Don't give up on God, cause he won't rely upon you. You say no. Thank you, God. You said you was gonna do it. And I believe you're gonna do it. Right now. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. 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 I bless the Lord this afternoon in His presence to all of our ministers, elders, preachers of the house, and all the other members of the gospel of Jesus Christ's race, to all the people of God. I thank you and bless His holy name. Knowing, I don't know about you, but I just believe I'm in the right place at the right time. I still declare no weapon from my excellence of the gospel. The glory of God will be in the glory of God. The glory of God will be in the glory of God. The glory of God will be in the glory of God. The glory of God will be in the glory of God. The glory of God will be in the glory of God. We don't get the way, I don't know. I don't care who the top from, I don't care who the top. God, we will do it. God, do it. That's why they hear me all the time. I know you hang around, you should be back there with your head of chains. Sure, I didn't tell you he had my say, you should have got the one he had to say. Glory to God. Well, you should have got the one he had to say. Hallelujah. God is just good. All by himself. Thank you for this day. Let's go to St. John's 11th chapter. Of this text, because there is a word here that's been wandering around in my spirit for a few days. I was going to come back with last Wednesday night's message. If you want that one, you got to come back next Wednesday. Amen.
Amen.
Glory. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. So, the reason I know that's a word. This might want to work this morning. I want you to hear it. I am still a schooler as well. We're going to get this message out. Since I'm trying to do what I want to do, I'm going to dance my rules in this thing. Yes, sir. You don't know what I do. You don't know what I do. Yes, sir. I can hang out as long as you want to hang around. Yeah, I can hang around. No! Mother, you want to hang around? Hallelujah. Hallelujah. God is so good to us. Devil don't like it, and I don't like him either. Amen. I want to go back and preach this again. I've been here several times, and every time we go there, we always find some little nuggets. Yeah. Yes, sir. Turn something down. Amen.
Amen.
Glory unto God. Now the word here in this 11th chapter of St. John starting at the 3rd, the 2nd verse. Yes, turn all other mics off. Put all of them off except this one. Hallelujah. Turn everything off. Amen. Hallelujah. Yeah, I thought we had this thing under control. Amen. Somebody said, thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Holy Ghost.
Thank you,
Holy Ghost. One more still on somewhere. It was on being. Hallelujah. Yes, sir. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. There you go. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Thank you, Jesus. Starting at that 32nd verse, then when Mary was come to Jesus was and saw him, she fell down at his feet, saying unto him, Lord, if thou hadst been here, my brother had not died. When Jesus therefore saw her weeping, and the Jews also weeping which came with her, he groaned in his spirit and was troubled, and said, Where have ye laid him? They said unto him, Lord, come see. Jesus wept. Then said to the Jews, Behold how he loved him. And some of them said, Could not this man which opened the eyes of the blind have caused that even this man should not have died? Jesus therefore, against groaning in his spirit himself, come to the grave. It was a cave and a stone laid upon it. Jesus said, Take ye away the stone. Martha, the sister of him that was dead, said unto him, Lord, by this time he stinketh, for he has been dead 4 days. Jesus said unto her, Say I not thee that if thou wouldst believe, thou shouldest see the glory of God? Now, certainly, with the aid of the Holy Ghost, I want to talk about this message entitled From Deathbed to the Master's Table. And in other words, I come to remind somebody, I don't care what you've been through with, God still got you covered. I don't care how much pain you've had, God still got you covered. I don't care how much they talk about you, God still got you covered. In other words, there's no area on this universe that our God won't go and bring you out of it. Somebody said, Thank you, Holy Ghost. Thank you, Holy Spirit. I want you to kind of feel this morning, because I feel somebody's spirit said, How much more can I take? I've had enough. Let me tell you something, baby. Let me tell you something, my brother. It ain't too much for God. It ain't filled yet. The cup is not running over yet. The cup doesn't run over until God comes and bless you. Did you have a source of blessing? Somebody said, Can I get a source of blessing this morning? Well, glory to God. Don't come in here and bother your nerves this morning, but I think come in here and make you think a little bit this morning, because everybody in here can make it. Everybody in here has a chance. Don't worry about the challenges of life. Don't worry about the experiment of life. Don't worry about the stuff you've been through with. Don't worry about your experiences in life. Know that that was your deathbed. But you're on your way to the master's table. Somebody say, Anybody want the master's table? Anybody want to learn from the master's table? Anybody want to eat from the master's table? Take your seats. This is, to me, Sister Queen, is one of the most amazing passage of scripture in the entire Bible. And here we allowed to see the glory of God.
Yes.
It's like yourself, you find yourself in some dead situations, and then here comes God. You find some situations in your life that you don't have any answers for, and then God shows up. Not only does he show up, Brother Bear, but he comes with power and majesty of Christ's power. In other words, God will allow you to see him on the top immediately. Don't let the enemy try to play with you. You're serving God. God will show up and show out. God bring you above your situation when you think not. But the Bible says he is a man that see by the name of Lazarus goes from a sick bed to the master's table. Not all the brother Charlie go from a sick bed, but he went from a dead bed. Somebody else said, Thank you, Jesus. In other words, he had to go to the worst, but God will give the glory. And when God gets ready to get the glory, brother, he's going to get it. No matter where we are, no matter what we're going through with, God will get the glory. In this text, we see what Jesus did for Brother Lazarus. But we can also see what he can do for you and I today still.
Yeah.
This particular passage shows us how Jesus He can take you from a deathbed to his own table. If you don't know the Lord, then this would be a great day to come to him by faith. If you don't know him, that's a great time to tell the Lord to remember how good he has been. Because as long as you're still here, God has been good to you at some time or another, whether you realize it or not. I don't know about you, but I can't go to the graveyard. I don't trust that. All I want God to do is to take care of right now and bless even right now. That's why you give him all that you have. You got to keep you right now and bless you right now. Because everybody can experience what Lazarus experienced. Matter of fact, I don't believe nobody else can experience naturally what Lazarus experienced. That's why you got to learn how, first of all, to condition your faith. Get your faith in all of that God can bless you. See now here, this was a dead man, mother. Poor old Lazarus wasn't just sick any longer. The Bible says he was dead. He was in a tomb surrounded by his family mourning and his friends mourning, but he couldn't hear any of them. Now even the Bible says the Lord showed up at his grave, but he was unaware of the presence of the Lord. Now Lazarus was a dead man. He was unable to respond to any of his surroundings. Now in his condition, he was a picture of every person who does not know the Lord. In other words, if you don't know the Lord, you're dead. And I don't argue with you on that, because the Bible says, until you're able to accept the death of Jesus Christ and believe that he arose from the dead, you will still dead yourself. In other words, one thing about the Lord, he said, I'm going away to prepare a place for you. And not only will I go away to prepare a place for you, but I'm going to leave your comforter. And that comforter that he's leaving has left with us today. But it's still on the inside of your eye. In other words, if you don't feel him every now and then, you are a dead creature. Because every now and then, something I'll raise up in you and say, at the name of Jesus, everything is going to have mercy upon me. In other words, every now and then, you ought to be able to praise the Lord from on the inside. And not worry about what's going on around you. In other words, you got to understand that I got the Lord on the inside of me. And you can't get him until you accept him and believe that the Lord Jesus Christ still lives on the inside of you. Oh, what an anointing your life will have. Oh, what a change your life will have. You shouldn't want to take the Lord anywhere. So you know he didn't go there. You ought to know you're taking the Lord there as well. You should want to keep the Lord down. Because you see him to our assignment. Somebody ought to tell the Lord thank you. Show no thank you. But I got a living in this house. And we must understand also, the Bible says that he was possibly decayed. So when God really wants to use us, he will allow us to go to a worse situation. He will allow you to almost shift, but you didn't slide. You will almost go under, but you didn't go under. According to Mary, Martha Lazarus had been dead long enough for the decay to process and have set their body in a different formation. The Bible says he was just as dead as he could be, but his death was far more apparently. Dead is dead. Now in the New Testament, Jesus kind of recited through people. You do not know the difference between a resurrection and just the sign? You are alive forevermore. Jesus raised the daughter of Jairus. She had just died on Luke 8. And the bloom of life was still in evidence. Even over a cheat. So I don't know about you. He also raised the widow of a man's son, Luke 7. He'd also been dead. The Bible says for several hours. He had also taken out a better place when Jesus passed by. His body had already gone cold, and the effects of death were surely the evidence. Jesus also raised Lazarus when Lazarus arrived at his tomb. He had been buried for 4 days. He had been buried long enough the poor was sick. About you. You may not be sinking, but your spirit is dead. You may not be afraid, but your spirit is dead. Only because you never accepted the Lord Jesus Christ. When you accept the Lord Jesus Christ in your life, your whole life begin to change. Can nobody tell you that who you used to be? All I know is that the Lord has changed my life. Now all I know, the Lord has brought me to where I used to be. So right now, I got nothing to do for yesterday. But I repeat it and ask the Lord if you will accept the chance. And when the Lord gives you accept your chance, you tell the devil you're now divorced. I've been changed. I got a new man. I got a new place to go. I got a new lover, I got a new friend, I got a new spouse, I got a new best friend. All I know is the Lord changed me, He changed you. All I know, He laid His hands on me one day, but running now. In my feet, my head, in my hand, laughter on my face, said run on, I don't know about you,
given up on him. In their minds, he is
dead and gone and nothing more can be done about it. But had this been any other cemetery, I may have agreed with them. But there was one different that day. Jesus Christ was on his way there. And when Jesus Christ is on his way coming to your situation, and your devil in hell can stop him, but he got his eyes on you. Notice when he got his eyes on you, and nothing will change it. God has forgiven you for all of your sins. He got his eyes on you. That's why you got to know that you know that you know. And everything is all right now. But you know, the Lord Jesus Christ doesn't bring life to your dead souls, because you're doomed as well. Jesus and Jesus alone makes a difference in the life of a dead sinner. We may give up on folks like the scribe did with Lazarus, but thank God Jesus doesn't operate like that. When I look like that, and life looked like that, no hope, Lord Jesus Christ came to Lazarus when he lay in the darkness. And he changed everything for him. What has been done for you, God will do it again. And whatever you need even for your children, God will do it again. Even when it looked kind of bleak, God will do it again and again. That was a call the Bible says for Lazarus. That was a personal call. See, I know when the Lord gave me a personal call. You listen to come when the Lord gave me a personal call. Come as around and begin to act. I don't know about you. That's only to sidetrack you. But when you do that, you know that you know. You shut everything off and go with the Lord. You shut everything down and go with the Lord. And I believe a lot of work with the Lord. He went all the way to death just to bring it home to Lord. Because every now and then it got to look like you're gone. It got to look like no life exists in front of me. But when the Lord really the one that needs you, the one that needs you alone, every area around you has got to be shut down. Because when the merciful of God is coming to your house, and when the merciful God began to come to your house, everybody around you started acting up. Even the ones you thought loved you started acting up. But when I'm learning people about that jealousy, is the major demon in this world. That will take away your dreams, take away your joy, take away your power. But I want you to understand, you can't help anybody. You can learn to stand on your own two feet. And you can learn to stand on your own two feet. Ain't nothing the devil can do to you. Because whatever comes your way, you got to tell him whatever the Lord wants you to do. Well, the Lord won't be me. That's where I be. Boy, I want you to know the loudness as I began to read this text. We weren't just in a graveyard, but I was all kind of tunes around. The Bible in the Bible here says that Lazarus was exemplified before Jesus was born to him. He made a tune, it wasn't just a tune, brother, that the tune had a rock in it, a stone in it, and in other words, he was struck between a rock and a hard place. You better get this word. You will find yourself stuck between a rock and a hard place. You will say, Jesus, say, all that rock, All that sorrow, can be the way. Need a man moved. They wanted that rock. He gave that rock enough life. And tell that rock, use Lazarus. And in the words, mother, how I know that Jesus called the right name. You got an answer. I'm going to say you're all right. When God will do something for you, if a man's in a bad situation, just to bless you, I need him right now. In other words, whatever story is in your life, I'm going to love him. I scream, life in a bad situation, and transform you, and translate to you, and transport you, give you your life. Be a doer. I said, be a doer. Sometimes you can't see the Lord. You can't turn some stuff and loose. Sometimes you can turn some family loose. You can turn some friends loose. You can turn some one wish within the loose. Sometimes all they can see is what you've been through. All they can see is how bad you used to be. They can't see what God is doing in the life. But I love it. Even the strangers. Gotta give the strangers a new family. Because you gonna die who you are. I don't care how saved and sanctified you just got, you're still human. And you can't take me so much. Anybody here? Anybody here? Anybody here? Just a few more minutes. I'm gonna be out of your way. The Bible. Lord Jesus called out the tomb. He issued a very personal call. He specifically called for Lazarus to come out. That was a call that no one else that day, but it was for Lazarus. I used to think before I really got into the revelation of this word that if you said dead, gotta get up. Grandma, granddaddy, everybody got up. But that's not what he said. Not only that, it wasn't that kind of grave. Anybody here? You gotta read the words, you gotta get into it. There's a purpose of why some of us end up in situations that we do. So God can use us to get his glory. So he had Lazarus in a situation only Lazarus could really hear him. Could have been another name Lazarus out there, but that day Lazarus was in a cemetery all by himself. Anybody here? That was for no one else to hear except Lazarus. That was a call designed for one man and one man alone. People of God, the gospel call is not generally a call to all men. It's a call to individuals from the Holy God. Even today, we may have 100 different calls in here. And God can answer them all at one time.
Yes.
But you got to be first seeking your call.
Yes.
Hearing your call. Some of y'all sitting in the mile, what am I going to do when I get home? I'm going to cook for dinner. I'm going to eat for dinner. Who am I going to call when I get home and tell them how Bishop preached? This ain't for them. This is for those that are alive in here. Because if it was for them, they would have been here.
Amen.
Yes, sir.
I can't hear nobody.
Come on, Bishop.
Yes, sir.
This is for you and you alone.
Yes.
To get to come out of where you are.
Yeah.
I don't ever want to go back and apologize for what God is doing, for what he's done. Because he didn't just do it for me, but he did it for what? His glory. Uh-huh. And what God does for his glory is going to dictate you through the rest of your years of life. Uh-huh. But however, as we know that the Lord will intensify his call without giving you more pain. God has a purpose in every situation, in every life, every lifestyle, and every place you go. God has planted a blessing there from you. See, the problem is we still hadn't got delivered from our yesterday. We're so afraid that we're going to run into our yesterday that we can't take care of our today.
Amen.
If you really think about it, your yesterday was your own fault. I can't hear nobody.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
It was your fault. And you still worried about it, dreaming about your yesterday, rather than say, Lord, I thank you for keeping me and delivering me from my yesterday. See, until you let that old wine go, you can't taste the new wine. Just, the mouth just going, trying to taste what you used to taste, it ain't going to happen. Because you still holding the same old bottles. What you call this? Jesus. Oh, taste and see that the Lord is good. And he will make everything all right. Not only was it a personal call, but it was a precise call. The call was so very clear. That day, God said, Jesus said, God's name, come forth. Jesus told Lazarus exactly what he was supposed to do, the Bible says. When he come calling, there was be no doubt as to what he wants you to do. When he comes calling, he will call you by your name. He will call you because you're believing in faith. He will call you. God get ready for you to win the lottery. He'll call you. Right now, you just practice as an exercise. But he get ready for you to come out of your dilemma. He'll call you out.
Yes.
Some of us can't get a call because we had purpose in our heart to bless him.
Oh,
well, I'm an old father. I'm going to cruise. Call Drunken Ned to see what he's doing. You purpose in your heart and invite God into your discovery, your life will never go backwards.
Amen.
As soon as it's all gone, here you come back.
All right. Oh, yeah.
Uh-oh.
Yes, sir.
But Lazarus had a call that could not change, but only change his name of a second time.
Yes. Yes, Lord.
Lazarus got a call from the Lord. If you ever get a call from the Lord, it'll change your whole life. Some of us get calls, brother, and we want to change, but the stuff around us won't let us change. You're bold enough to tell them that I've been changed. But the Lord has lifted me. You're going to say, what time? Somebody say, glory to God.
Glory to God.
But when God wants to use you, he will give you a foundation that will change your whole life.
Man.
That's why Lazarus had to go to the grave. Lazarus didn't go to the grave, all of them around him would have missed a miracle. But they got a miracle. Because Lazarus' whole life was used by Jesus Christ. When your life is used by Jesus Christ, then you don't have to worry about your miracles. Your miracle is clear and clarity. And finally, when the call comes, it will be so powerful. Gotta break every tradition. Gotta break every situation. See, this was a powerful call for Lazarus. It brought him out of death and darkness into the light and life. It changed everything for this man forever. Such a powerful move unto the master's table. Not only, the Bible says when he got up with graven clothes still on. Everything about him was still there. And the Lord allowed him to seek it off and come forth. When you come forth, you got to leave some stuff behind.
Yes, Lord.
You can't spend a lifetime talking about what you've been through with. Can't spend a lifetime talking about who did you wrong. All you need to talk about is God did it. God did it. God kept me. God brought me out. He changed me. Changed my whole life. Changed everything about me. Changed my communications. Where I used to curse, now I'm praying God. Where I used to drink, now I'm drinking the whole wine. All I know is the Lord brought me from a mighty long way. The Lord brought me into a new life. The Lord healed my body. My limbs faint zone. And it's not that ready to be nothing. You got to look at yourself and say, look at me now. Look at me now. You can be on Sunday morning trying to get over Saturday night. But Sunday morning now, I'm trying to get to the house as fast as I can. But all I know, the Lord is leading me. Brought me through. Out. Oh, Lord. Oh, Lord. I'm changed. Thank God I changed. Thank God I changed. Thank God I changed. It ain't like I used to be. Thank God I changed. Thank God I'm set free. And the moment I used to be in pain, I saw the Lord with his legs, hands on me. Lord, I give up. I invite you to come. Man, woman, boy, or girl. I invite you to come on home. Join in. Get with the Lord and I see you. That may be you if you stand all over this house. Come on to Jesus. Tell yourself that I'm next in line for my miracle. For my miracle. That may you come on home. Come on to Jesus. Come on. Come on to Jesus. Yep, there's a miracle in this room. What's your name? There's a healing in this room. And that's your name on it. Come on. Come on. Come on. Come on. Come on. Come on. Don't hold back, bro. Come on. Come on. Come on. Come on. You're allowed to come across this beautiful God. I'm going to bless you with first of all. And God, I pray that you the mother of my sin, God, that you would change their hearts and change their minds even right now, God. Give them the victory, God. Give them victory right now. Heal and set free, God, God. If it is sick among us, God, you bless them right now, God. Deliver them right now, God. Heal them right now. Jesus, amen. 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 Amen.